for many of you, your mobile phone's not just for calls, of course. It's got your diary in it, your entertainment. I've got some smoking playlists on
mine. You do.
Your camera, it's all rolled into one.
Yes, and if the ads are to be believed, you can do all of those things while floating in the air or sitting on the ocean floor.
But does the reality really live up to the hype? Alistair investigates.
They're not the country's number one fishing spots, but Taranaki's rivers have been known to produce the goods.
I'm no king fisherman, but I'll get a trout out here sometimes.
Here is the Hangatahua or Stony River, and he might not be a king, but Leland Sawyer is certainly a keen fisherman.
This one's probably one of the nicest to be at in general, like whether you're swimming or fishing or anything, it's a beautiful spot.
He's right. It's the kind of spot you want to capture on camera. So last October, he spent $850 on an iPhone SE second generation for the very purpose of snapping those cool pics.
Went down to the river and fishing for a couple of hours. I was like looking around, beautiful weather, clear water. I was like, oh my God, this is gonna make such a good photo. I got my phone out, ditched my backpack and my rod, waded in, took a quick little pano video showing the rocks under the river, looked at the video, I'm like, oh, this looks amazing, stoked.
But within 10 minutes of taking that amazing video, Leland says the camera lens started fogging up.
I'm like, oh no, what have I done?
And later, the whole phone went dead.
Yeah, I was pretty gutted.
Leland went back to the store the same day, where he says he was relieved to be told his phone can go underwater at 1 metre depth for 30 minutes. 2 Degrees in Taranaki sent the phone away to their third-party repair company. And surprise, surprise, it came back saying there was water damage. Oh, and that Leland would have to pay $550 to repair it.
When they called me back, they said that water damage isn't covered by the warranty. And I thought, hey, the whole reason I bought this phone was to avoid water damage. It's supposed to be water resistant.
Now, in the fine print, Apple do explain that water damage isn't covered under their warranty. They also say their phones are tested in controlled lab conditions. But if they say something is water resistant, it should still be working after being on water, right?
Yes. As far as it's advertised, it should have been working. They say they're water resistant, which doesn't necessarily mean waterproof. I would go as far as to say there is no waterproof phone. They are only made to sort of repel water, not keep it out entirely.
Apple told us it doesn't portray iPhone as an underwater camera. More on their response in a moment. But first, bear with me as we get technical, because it's time to talk IP ratings.
If you want an IP rating, IP68 is the best one, and if you want to take your phone underwater, it may well survive, but as we found out, there's no guarantee.
So an IP rating is a two-digit grading system. The numbers show how well an iPhone can be protected against the elements.
Leland's iPhone had an IP rating of 6.7. The 6 means it has full protection against dust, and the 7 means it's protected against full water immersion for up to 30 minutes at 1 metre max, whereas the Samsung Galaxy A8 has a 6.8 IP rating, which is as water resistant as you can get with phones. And that's exactly what Ash has.
Christmas Day, we went down for a swim. I decided to take some photos of my son. And the phone was working and then it stopped working and it got worse and worse. As soon as the phone got wet, the screen would start playing up. Samsung, in this case, should come to the party and just replace the phone because water got inside the phone and it's meant to be waterproof. Their waterproofing on the ads are very vague and it just doesn't seem right.
Well, under our Fair Trading Act, it's illegal for any business to mislead or deceive you about the things they sell, no matter how big the company.
Complaints about breaches of the Fair Trading Act go to the Commerce Commission. It told us...
Since January 2019, we've received a total of 14 complaints relating to Apple or Samsung phones and marketing claims about water resistance. 11 were about Apple and 3 were about Samsung. We do not have a current investigation open.
Apple didn't want to go on camera, instead it pointed us to the support page on their website, which clearly lists all the iPhones that can go on water and for how long. But then it says to avoid swimming or bathing with your phone, or intentionally submerging it underwater. When we asked for further clarification, we just kept being referred back to the support page.
So here's the thing, normally this is the part where we go busting in, all cameras rolling, but Apple don't have an office here in New Zealand, making it way harder to chew them out.
And as for Samsung, it says if there's water damage to an IP-rated phone, it'll repair or replace it, except if the phone is already damaged. Samsung goes on to say that it ensures it explains the water resistance capabilities of its devices in its marketing. Samsung's actually in court in Australia right now, facing accusations it's misled consumers on exactly this issue. But retailers have to do their part too.
I think it's perfectly reasonable for a consumer buying from a retailer to assume that they know about the products they're selling. So it will say it's water and dust resistant, and that's a nice bit of marketing. But on several of these products, if you go to the website and look in the fine print, it will say these aren't permanent conditions, or they've tested it in these things, but still it's kind of evasive language.
In Leland's case, it's good news. 2Degrees has agreed he should get a replacement phone. It says,
"We're committed to looking after our customers. We ask customers to come and see us if they have any issues."
And JB Hi-Fi, where Ash bought his phone, are keen to chat to him and say that customers returning a faulty product are given a refund, replacement or repair. And even if the phone is out of their warranty, they know they've got responsibilities under the CGA. So before you dive in, do some research, or be like Leland and keep your phone firmly in your pocket while you fish, no matter how pretty the spot.
Gotta say, waterproof, water resistance, splash resistance, it is all a shemozzle, which is a very hard word to spell.
Big word too, another big word for you, misleading. It's an even bigger claim, but it seems to us like what's being promised isn't the reality. So what can you do to make sure you know what you're actually buying?
First, before you hit the shops, do your research. Look online, talk to your friends and family, work out what you want from your phone.
That's right. If you're a keen gamer, wannabe photographer, or just want to send messages, there are different options for your needs.
And in terms of durability, search online for that IP rating Alistair mentioned. The higher the number, the more dust or splash resistant the phone is meant to be.
That's right. And as we hope we've shown, no mobile phone is waterproof. The technology just isn't there yet.
And finally, if your phone starts playing up, do not be afraid to take it back to the retailer, even if the warranty's ended. The Consumer Guarantees Act is there for you.
It is.